And Zechariah is a righteous man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen to be a prophet and a messenger from Bani Israel, since he is from the progeny and the offspring of Sulaiman alayhi salam. So he's from Bani Israel, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen Bani Israel, and Allah had blessed Bani Israel with a blessing that Allah did not bless any nation, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent so many prophets and messengers to Bani Israel. No nation had experienced the number of prophets and messengers that Allah had sent to them the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent to Bani Israel. Zechariah, the son of Dan, from the offspring of Sulaiman, a righteous man that used to live in Damascus. Now the sacred place, a holy place, which is also holy to us and sacred to us, is Jerusalem, Bayt al-Maqdis. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen Mecca over Bayt al-Maqdis. But that doesn't mean Bayt al-Maqdis is no longer sacred. It is sacred. But in ranking, number one, Masjid Allah al-Haram in Mecca. Then Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. Then Masjid al-Aqsa. Masjid al-Aqsa is a sacred place to us as Muslims. So Bani Israel had taken Masjid al-Aqsa and Jerusalem as a sacred place, as a sacred land. And the scholars and the monks of Bani Israel, they were at the service of Bayt al-Maqdis. They were at the service of Masjid al-Aqsa, which is the sacred mosque and the sacred place of worship in Jerusalem. So Zechariah alayhi salam decided to move from Damascus to Jerusalem, to be in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and deen of Allah azza wa jal, and worshipping Allah azza wa jal in Jerusalem. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he had chosen Zechariah alayhi salam to be the prophet and messenger, what comes with that? Test. Every blessing, there's a test. Nothing comes for free. You're a prophet and messenger, congratulations. But you know what? We're giving you a heads up. You're gonna be tested more than everyone else, including the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What was the first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? Iqra. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat down with Waraqah ibn Nawfal. What was the first thing that he told him? I wish you for my young man that will stand by your side when your people turn against you. No one had ever come with what you came with, which is the prophecy and the messengerhood, and people didn't turn against him. It's part of the package. You can't. It's part of the package. You're a prophet and messenger, but you know what? You're going to be tested. And the test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Zechariah alayhi salam encounter was that he didn't have children. His wife was barren. Zechariah, his wife was barren. According to the majority of the narrations, the wife of Zechariah is the sister of Maryam. Some other narrations say the wife of Zechariah is the auntie of Maryam. Regardless, sister or auntie, they were kings. They were kings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran Kareem, إِذْ قَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ عِمْرَانَ رَبِّ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي مُحَرَّرًا فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says before this verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَآلَ عِمْرَانَ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen Adam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen Nuh and their family. So Allah had chosen the family of Adam, and Allah had chosen the family of Nuh, and Allah had chosen Ibrahim, وَآلَ عِمْرَان, and the family of Imran over everyone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen the family of Adam and the family of Nuh and the family of Ibrahim and the family of Imran over the rest of the world. They were righteous people. Imran wasn't a prophet. And Imran is the father of Maryam. Imran is the father of Maryam. Imran was not a prophet. Imran was a righteous man. He was a scholar from the scholars of Bani Israel, and he was the headmaster scholar of the scholars of Bani Israel in Jerusalem. I want you to connect the story. So Imran, the father of Maryam, and also the father of the wife of Zechariah alayhi salam, Imran was a scholar from Bani Israel, a righteous man, an upright man, who had utmost respect amongst Bani Israel, and also he was the head and the master of the scholars of Bani Israel. إِذْ قَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ عِمْرَانَ رَبِّ إِنِّي نَظَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي مُحَرَّرًا فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Now I know we skipped the story, but the second story is connected to the first story. We're talking about Zechariah and his wife, but now we want to talk about the mother of the wife of Zechariah alayhi salam. And she is the wife of Imran, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when the wife of Imran, the mother of the wife of Zechariah, and the wife of Imran. When the wife of Imran said, Rabbi inni nadartu laka ma fi batni muharraran fataqabbal minni. Oh Allah, I devote what's in my stomach, which means, Ya Allah, I devote this pregnancy and the child that I'm about to deliver in your worship. Okay, so now we've got Imran, and Imran is the father of the wife of Zakaria and the father-in-law of Zakaria, and he's also the father of Maryam. His wife, okay, some narrations say her name was a specific name, this and that, Allahu A'lam, what was her name? His wife was a righteous woman, and Jerusalem is the hub, is the holy city for Bani Israel. And the scholars of Bani Israel used to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah azza wa jal, and learning about their religion, which is Islam, according to the Sharia of Sulaiman and Dawood, or according to the Sharia of Musa, wallahu ta'ala a'lam. They used to learn that in Jerusalem, and they used to dedicate, they used to devote their baby boy children in the service of Masjid al-Aqsa. So only male children were allowed to serve their religion, which is our religion, Islam, but different Sharia. Male children were allowed to be devoted in the service of Masjid al-Aqsa. So when the wife of Imran fell pregnant, she made dua. She said, Ya Allah, I devote this child that I'm going to give birth to in your service. She wanted to please Allah Azza wa Jal, and she wanted to dedicate and devote this child that's going to be delivered. She wanted him to be in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Masjid Aqsa. So what happened there? فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا قَالَتْ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنْثَى. When the wife of Imran gave birth, she gave birth to a female. Okay, but customary, only males who are allowed to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Masjid al-Aqsa. What am I going to do with this female? فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا قَالَتْ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنْثَى. Ya Allah, I've been making dua, and I made this dua. فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Ya Allah, accept from me. I want to devote this child in your service, but now I gave birth to this female child. How are we going to put a female child in your service when وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. Males and females are not the same. To Allah, they are equal. Male and female are equal. Man and woman are equal to Allah Azza wa Jal. Inna akramakum inda Allah atqakum. The most honorable unto Allah is the one that fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. But here, the difference between a male and a female is a male is allowed to be in the service of Masjid al-Aqsa, a female is not. But that doesn't make in a male better than the female, or the female better than male. Wa inni sammaytuha Maryam. Oh Allah, and I name her what? Maryam. So she named her as Maryam. وَإِنِّي أُعِيذُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. And Ya Allah, I seek refuge in you in protecting her from the shaitan. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, every child that's born, the shaitan will come and poke him. Whenever a child is born, whenever a baby is born, this baby cries, he or she, because they've been poked by the shaitan. Shaitan will come and poke him. Here you go, just to ignite the thing, just out of spitefulness, because shaitan doesn't like it as a human being. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, every baby that's born is poked by the shaitan, is touched by the shaitan, except Maryam and his son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected Maryam because of the dua of the mother of Maryam. وَإِنِّي أُعِيدُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمُ. Allah, I seek refuge in you to protect her and her progeny from the shaitan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected her and protected Isa alayhi salam. وَإِنِّي أُعِيذُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected Maryam. But now, they are stuck. She made a commitment. She made a vow that if she gives birth, that this child is going to be in the service of Masjid al-Aqsa, which is what? Which will be devoting himself in the worship of Allah Azza wa Jalla. But now she gave birth to a female. What is she going to do? It's only males who are allowed to be in the service of Masjid al-Aqsa and worship Allah Azza wa Jalla, and to be in the service of the scholars of Bani Israel, and to learn the deen from the scholars of Bani Israel. So the father of Maryam, Imran, who's the husband of the wife of Imran that gave birth, he gave a fatwa. He said, we need to fulfill this vow. We need to fulfill, we made a vow. We made a promise. And this promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no way out of it. We need to fulfill it. So he said, I'll build a small chamber, a small room in Masjid al-Aqsa just for her. We need to fulfill this vow. Our vow is that if Allah blesses us with a child, we're gonna dedicate this child in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This child came out to be a female. Females are not allowed to be in Masjid al-Aqsa and then serve as a Masjid al-Aqsa. We're gonna find a leeway, a way out of it. So we're gonna build a small chamber, mihrab, in Masjid al-Aqsa only for her. Because she's a female, she's by herself. And then the rest of males and the rest of the scholars, they could do whatever they want to do. فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا وكفلها زكريا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted it. Allah accepted this from Imran and the wife of Imran. Their commitment was, yeah Allah, the child that I'm going to give birth to, the child that Allah is going to bless us, we want him to be in your service. It's a female, yeah Allah, there's a way out of it, we're going to build a room for her. Allah said, we accept that from him. فَتَقَبَّلَهَا. And Allah accepted Maryam. And Allah blessed her. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَتَقَبَّلَهَا رَبُّهَا بِقَبُولٍ حَسَنٍ. Allah accepted Maryam in the best form of acceptance. وَأَنْبَتَهَا نَبَاتًا حَسَنًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Maryam grow in the best of growth. She grew up in the best of growth. She was a woman while everyone else at her age still look like babies, if you want to say, still like kids. Allah blessed her spiritually and physically and mentally. That's why Maryam is that righteous woman. So Allah had accepted her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made her grow and brought her up in a good manner, in a very good, healthy manner. وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Zakaria be her guardian. Okay, what's that got to do with this? What happened to her father? Imran is the chief of the scholars of Bani Israel. So he is the master, the most senior scholar of Bani Israel, that the scholars of Bani Israel look up to and respect. When he passed away, he's going to take care of Maryam. Maryam needs to be in the care of someone. Maryam needs to be in the care of someone. So obviously the students of Imran, who's the father of Maryam, they all start to compete with one another. Each one of them wants to be that guardian that takes care of the daughter of his master, of his teacher, of his scholar. So they disputed amongst each other. Each one of them says, no, I'm going to take care of the daughter of my teacher. I'm going to take care of the daughter of our scholar. I'm going to take care of the daughter of Imran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired them, and that's one of the customs they used to have. Let us get a sign from Allah. Let's see. Let us get a sign from Allah Azza wa Jalla, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose. وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ إِذْ يُلْقُونَ أَقْلَامَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ يَكْفُلُ مَرْيَمَا وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ إِذْ يَخْتَصِمُونَ. Allah is saying to Muhammad, you went there when the scholars of Bani Israel were fighting over who's going to be the guardian of the daughter of Imran. So they went to the river, and each one of them had a pen. And each one of them knew their pen. Oh no, this is my pen. It's not like, wallah, you go and buy Parker pens and they all look the same. You make your own pen, you know which one is yours. So the scholars of Bani Israel went to the river. And they threw their pens in the river. All of them went with the stream. Except one was going against the stream. How's that going to work? The water's flowing this way. How's this one? There's 10 pens, 20 pens are going with the stream, with the flow, except one going against the stream. It was the pen of Zakaria. Is that a sign from Allah or not? Of course it is. It's a miracle. The flow is going one direction and the pen is going the other direction. You're swimming against the opposite direction. Has the pen swimming opposite direction? Has this object going against the wave? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ. Oh Muhammad, you went there when the scholars of Bani Israel, إِذْ يُلْقُونَ أَقْلَامَهُمْ, when they threw and they cast their pens in that river. All their pens was going with the flow except one. The one that was going against the flow was the pen of Zakaria. This is the sign from Allah that Allah had chosen Zakaria to be the guardian of Maryam. وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا. Now, Zakaria alayhi salam is the guardian of Maryam. And Zakaria is also the husband of the sister of Maryam. And according to some narrations, the auntie of Maryam. But I lean more towards the sister of Maryam. So Zakaria is also the brother-in-law of Maryam. So he's got that relationship. He's taking care of the sister. He's taking care of the sister of his wife, his sister-in-law. So not only that Allah had chosen him to be the guardian of the daughter of Imran, but he's also the guardian of his sister-in-law that was young. She was in a chamber attached to Masjid al-Aqsa. And she's the first one, she's the first female to ever live in Masjid al-Aqsa or within the vicinity of Masjid al-Aqsa, because her mother and her father needed to fulfill their vow and they promised Allah Azza wa Jal. And Zakaria, as her guardian, he used to check up on her. From time to time, he'll go into that chamber, check up on Maryam. Everything okay? Do you need something? Do you want something? You need to do this, guide her, teach her. But subhanAllah, every time he comes into this chamber, he sees something amazing. He sees food there, fruits that grow and harvest in winter, in summer. Or fruits that grow in summer, in winter. Ya Maryam, anna laki hadha, where did you get these fruits from? If I want to go and buy these fruits right now in summer, I can't get them, they are winter fruits. And if I want to buy them right now in winter, I can't get them, they are summer fruits. Where did you get them from? قالت هو من عند الله. It is from Allah. Allah, is it hard for Allah to give her the fruits of summer in winter or the fruits of winter in summer? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to send it to her. Zakaria alayhi salam, prophet and messenger. Prophet and messenger saw a miracle appearing and emerging on the hands of a child. And Maryam yet hasn't even reached the age of puberty. Still a child. فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted her and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made her grow in the best of growth. And not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted her. She was a righteous child. Later on she became a righteous woman. But before she was a righteous woman, she was also a righteous child. She was an example to Bani Israel. To the extent that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make miracles appear on the hands of Maryam. Zakaria is amazed. I know we're talking about Zakaria, but we went into the story of Maryam, but it's connected to the story of Zakaria. At that time, Zakaria was about 100 years old. And his wife is 99 years old. Zakaria is 100 years old. And his wife is 99 years old. Oldies. And his wife is an old woman. So in this day and age, to hear of a 99 year old woman falling pregnant, nah, this is far-fetched. No way. What are you talking about? 99 years old. Well, like when you hear a woman falling pregnant when she's 50 years old, everyone will be talking about it. What about double the age? Zakaria alayhi salam, living all those years, all his life as a prophet and messenger, he's longing for a child. He wants a child. He wants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him a child. And Allah Azza wa says in the Quran al-Kareem, ذِكْرُ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ عَبْدَهُ زَكَرِيَّا. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that came down upon Zakaria. إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. When he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in private, قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني. Ya Allah, I'm getting so old. واشتعل الرأس شيبة. And you could see the grey hair filling my head. ولم أكن بدعائك ربي شقيا. And I'm always resorting to you, Ya Allah. I'm always going to you, Ya Rab. وإني خفت الموالي من ورائي وكانت امرأتي عاقرة. Ya Allah, I'm afraid that the generations that will come after us, they're not righteous. But my wife is barren. I need a successor, Ya Rab. هنالك دعا زكريا ربه. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, when he entered the chamber of Maryam alayhi salam, and he saw the fruits of winter in summer, and sometimes he sees the fruits of summer in winter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can make whatever he wants. So he raised his hands to Allah in discreet and private, and he said, قال ربي هب لي من لدنك يا رب. Ya Allah, grant me a child. Ya Rab, grant me a child. I'm old and my wife is barren. Not only that he's old, being old is one thing, but barren. That's it. No children. Track record shows she's never felt pregnant. She did not even fall pregnant when she was young. She's gonna fall pregnant when she's old. Ya Rab, Ya Allah, I want you, Ya Allah, to grant me a child, especially after he saw that miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make however he wants, in any way, in any form, in any shape that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted this dua. فَنَادَتْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَابِ. وَزَكَرِيَّا عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his own closed chamber. Angels came down to him, called upon Zakariya. Ya Zakariya, inna Allah yubashiruka biyahya. Oh Zakariya, we are coming down with the good news to you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow upon you and grant you a child. His name is Yahya. Yahya. Yani, I'm old. My wife is old. When she was young and I was young, we didn't have children. How are we going to have children right now? Not only that he's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, not only that Allah is going to grant you a child. No. أن الله يبشرك بيحيى مصدقا بكلمة من الله وسيدا وحصورا ونبيا من الصالحين. Not only that Allah is going to grant you, not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to bless you with a child, but this child is going to be a righteous, upright child and a prophet and a messenger after you. He was a prophet missing during his time, but after him following his footsteps. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives further description about Yahya alayhi salam. Sayyid. So he's a respected man, an honorable man. Wahasur. Allah told Zakariya alayhi salam before the birth of Yahya, Yahya shall never get married. Your son will never come up to you and say, Dad, I found my partner, my dream woman. Alhamdulillah. I'm already stressed over my kids when they come to me at that moment. Alhamdulillah, Zakariya didn't have that. Didn't have to stress about that moment of marrying off his son. Allah, you could see the fathers at the back, they stressed about their children. Wahasura, Yahya shall never get married. It's not that Yahya doesn't desire a woman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed upon him, he doesn't get married, that's it. So before he's born, we turn you from now. He will never ever get married. He will never ever have any relationship with another woman. Not because of anything, because that's what Allah decreed on him. That's what Allah decreed on him. Sayyidan wa hasuran wa nabiyyan min as-salihin. He's a righteous prophet and messenger. Subhanallah. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Lam naj'al lahu min qablu samiyya. We're gonna bless you with a child. His name is Yahya. No one in the past had ever been named Yahya. First ever. I know the English or the Bible refers to him as what? John. But I like Yahya. Let's stick to Yahya. But it's John. In the Bible, it's John. But Yahya. لَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ سَمِيَّا. This prophet and messenger, his name is Yahya. We've never ever named anyone, or no one in the past had ever ever been named as Yahya. Now obviously Zakariya alayhi salam was amazed. Allahu Akbar. Allah is going to bless me with a child. When I was young, I was looking forward to this. Now Allah is going to bless me with a child. So he said, قال ربي أن يكون لي غلام. How is this possible? Ya Rab, how is it possible? وقد بلغت من الكبر وامرأتي عاقرة وقد بلغت من الكبر عتيا. My wife is so old and she's barren. Old and barren. And I'm old. قال كذلك قال ربك هو علي هين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied back to him and said, it's easy. وقد خلقتك من قبل. I created you, Zakariya. What's so hard about me creating a child for you? Easy. It's not hard. They came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam making mockery over the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. You believe that after we die, your Lord is going to bring us back alive after we die and we turn into dust. The Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, don't ask that question. Ask how did you come from the very beginning. You worried about the second time. You should be worried about how did you emerge and come out from the first time, not the second time. So it's not hard on Allah the first time, definitely it's going to be a lot easier on the second time, even though the word hard or easy, that is, it doesn't even apply on Allah Azza wa Jal. وَقَدْ خَلَقْتُكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَمْ تَكُ شَيْئًا. I created you before, O Zakaria, you were nothing. It's easy on me. قَالَ هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيَّن. Allah said, it's easy on me to create and make your wife fall pregnant. And I created you from before. قَالَ رَبِّ جَعَلْ لِي آيَةً. Ya Allah, Ya Rabb, oh, thank you. But can you give me a sign? I don't want to be just shocked overnight that my wife is pregnant. Just give me a sign. Like, you're so overwhelmed, so happy, you know, when you so happy, you know what? You want this. Okay, but when? You know, you just want to know when. Okay, something is coming. You like to know when. So Zakaria alayhi salam is a prophet, but he's a human being at the end of the day. He's got desires. And he's got emotions. Ya Allah, this is overwhelming news for me. I've been waiting for this moment for years. Now it happens when I'm so old that all my hair turned into grey and my wife is barren and old. Ya Allah, I thank you. But give me a sign at least, you know. Give me the heads up. Give me the heads up when my wife falls pregnant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, قَالَ آيَتُكَ أَلَّا تُكَلِّمَ النَّاسَ ثَلَاثَ لَيَالٍ سَوِيَّا. Allah told him, we'll give you the heads up. The moment your wife falls pregnant is that moment that your tongue can't speak and communicate with people anymore. You want to speak? You can't speak. You want to talk? You can't talk. Remember Allah? Your tongue starts to flow. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, MashaAllah. Read the book of Allah? Flows. Come and talk to him and them? You can't. You want to talk? You can't. Illa ramza, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, except a gesture, signs. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ. That day, while he's praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah azza wa jal, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his chamber, he comes out to communicate with his people, to communicate with his followers, to communicate with his students. Zakaria can't talk anymore. Ya Rasulullah, or the messenger of Allah, Zakaria, 1, 2, 3, 4, what's this? Can't talk. This is the sign that Allah gave him. 3 days, he can't talk, only a gesture. What about, read the book of Allah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. Zakaria, no more talking. Who made him do that? It's not an act. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ فَأَوْحَىٰ إِلَيْهِمْ أَنْ سَبِّحُوا بُكْرَةً وَعَشِيَّةً. He came out from his chamber, can't communicate anymore. He knew, he was waiting for this moment. That's it, this is the sign from Allah. Your wife is pregnant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. We also rectified, fixed his wife. Rectified what? She couldn't fall pregnant. Allah made her fall pregnant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed upon her to fall pregnant. So now Zakaria alayhi salam is awaiting. Awaiting for what? For that moment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless him with that child that he's been waiting for a very long time. Unexpected. It's a miracle. When she was young, she could not even fall pregnant. Now she's 99 years old. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed upon her to fall pregnant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say, Ya Yahya, خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا. Yahya alayhi salam grows up in a household of prophecy, a righteous mother, and not only a righteous father, a prophet and a messenger of Allah. His father is a prophet and a messenger of Allah. So he grows in the care of Allah first and foremost, and the care of his father, the prophet and the messenger of Allah, Zakaria, and his righteous mother, the wife of Zakaria. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran Kareem, Ya Yahya, خذ الكتاب بقوة. Take the book of Allah with full determination. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the book at a young age. But the scholars say prophecy only happens by the age of puberty. But this is a preparation for the prophecy. The miracles that appear on the hands of a prophet and messenger before the age of puberty, preparation. But when do they become endorsed? When they reach the age of puberty. Say, Yahya alayhi salam is a prophet and messenger of Allah. And Allah Azza said about him to be a prophet and messenger of Allah before he was even born. But when does he get the approval? When does he get the license, the badge of a prophet and messenger? By the age of puberty. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also praises Yahya alayhi salam. وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحُكْمَ صَبِيًّا. And we granted Yahya alayhi salam wisdom and judgment from a young age. It's been narrated by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that when the children used to play, they used to come up to another children, a child, Yahya alayhi salam. They used to go up to him and say, come and play with us. He used to reply back to them and say, we weren't created to play. Young child. Now the adults, we are created to play, not the children. Children is a different world now these days, this day and age. The adults, 50 years old, still playing on PS4. 50 years old, huh? 50 years old, playing on PS4. Yahya alayhi salam, at a young age. Let's play. We're not created for playing. What are you created for? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَحَنَانَ مِنْ لَدُنَّا وَزَكَى وَكَانَ تَقِيَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say that a great compassion from us was zakah and growth. Wa kana taqiyan, and he was righteous. Wa barran biwaliday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also speaks about Yahya alayhi salam and he's dutiful, respectful to his parents. Wa lam yakun jabbaran asiyan, and he was never ever disobedient. Allah preserved him. Prophets and messengers are preserved from sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved Yahya alayhi salam from sins before the age of puberty and before the prophecy and after the age of puberty and after the prophecy. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ وُلِدَ وَيَوْمَ يَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ يُبْعَثُ حَيَّ. And peace be upon Yahya alayhi salam from the time that he was given birth to and the day that he dies and the day that he is resurrected. Allah blessed him before birth, during birth, after birth, during his life, during his death, after his death, and the day he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yahya alayhi salam, a prophet and a messenger of Allah. He was young, wise, reached the age of puberty, prophet and messenger, righteous, calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, standing for the truth, not compromising on the fundamentals of the deen, following the footsteps of his father, Zakariya alayhi salam. But during his time, there was a tyrant king that ruled Bani Israel. This tyrant king, he's so tyrant and oppressive. He fell in love with his niece. And we know, Islamically, you can't get married to your niece. And his niece wanted to get married to her uncle. Why? Because she is greedy. She's going to become a queen. Not because, wallah, she loved her uncle. He's probably a khatiyar about to die. But materialism, greed, I could be the queen. But there was a big problem for this king to get married to his niece. It's not permissible. It's forbidden. How are you going to do that? Your flock and your people turn against you. Who's going to accept it to get married to your niece? Go and ask Yahya. See if he'll give you the fatwa. So Yahya alayhi salam said, haram, not acceptable, and he delivered a sermon. So the dream of the niece of the king had not come true. She was devastated. She was looking for the opportunity. It was a great hope for her to be the queen, to have this authority, to have this wealth, to have this respect, to have this prestige. But now it's not going to happen anymore because of this man. His name is Yahya. And the uncle, who's the king, is refusing because he can't. There'll be a big rival. There'll be a big uprise that he went against the values or they went against the teachings of their own customs, of their own people. So one day, the niece of the king that was interested in her uncle, she plotted her uncle to drink wine and become drunk. And then she started to seduce him. And while he was drunk and seduced, he said, I want you. She said, no, you can't have me. Why I can't have you? Because Yahya said otherwise. He said, you can't. He said, but I don't care about Yahya. Then she told him, if you want to get married to me, you bring me the head of Yahya as my dowry. And the king is what? Not only that he's an oppressor, unjust and corrupt and disobedient to Allah, but he's in a state of drunkenness. He's not there. So he ordered his soldiers to go and pursue Yahya alayhi salam and to find him and to kill him and chop his head off and bring his head on a silver platter to his future wife, his niece. So they did so. They caught him, killed him, chopped his head off, put it on a silver platter or golden platter, and brought his head as a dowry to the niece of the king. How old was Yahya alayhi salam at that time? He was only 30 years old. But that wasn't enough. We got rid of Yahya, but what about his father? His father's not going to keep quiet. Zakariya, go and get him too. So he ordered the soldiers to go and pursue and search for Zakariya alayhi salam. Zakariya alayhi salam is running away from them until he went into the bush, into the jungle. And he commanded that tree to open for him. So he went inside that tree and hid inside that tree. But then the shaitan came and directed the soldiers of the king where Zakariya alayhi salam is in. So they chopped that tree into two halves and killed Zakariya alayhi salam. During that time, he's close to age to Yahya, and Yahya is only 3 months older than him, Isa alayhi salam. And the story of Isa alayhi salam is an amazing story, him and his mother. And after the death and the killing and the murder of those two great prophets, Zakariya and Yahya, inshallah next week, we'll talk about Prophet Isa alayhi salam. An interesting story, an amazing line that we hear of Isa and his mother Maryam alayhim assalam. We'll leave that inshallah next Thursday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who listen and hear and act upon what they listen and hear. Subhanaka wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
This person's destiny. Inshallah, Jannah, Jannah, Jannah.